The family, it's so important. Julie, have you ever thought of a family business?
No.
That's the interesting thing about this family that you're about to meet. They love working together.
Oh yeah, great Italian family, great Italian food. It's downtown. Paul Poteet's gonna take us to Iozzo's.
Look at all of those guys. Those guys all have something in common with this lady.
Yes.
Who is our guest today. You know, Paul Poteet's gotta eat. And so I heard from friends of mine that the place to come is downtown and Katie Harris is downtown. And what's your connection with all those
sure.
guys?
Sure, well, the gentlemen that you see there are my great-grandfather, and my great-uncle. They were the founders and the proprietors of Iozzo's Garden of Italy when it was originally opened in 1930.
So the place is rocking. It's a place people go to celebrate special events, and then something happens.
Absolutely. So in October of 1940, my grandfather Dominic was tending bar. A couple gentlemen come into the restaurant and sit up at the bar and order a few drinks. Well, at some point during the evening, they began making passes towards my great aunt Mary. Well, my grandfather didn't like that too much, so he kindly asked them to leave. They didn't like that too much. They began arguing with my grandpa. Well, the argument turned into a fight. The fight basically turned into an all-out brawl where they had my grandfather on the ground beating him to death. My great-grandfather, who's in the office, comes out and sees what's going on, is like, my God, they're gonna kill my son. So he goes back into the office and grabs the gun, comes out and shoots the guy, who at this point is on top of my grandfather, strangling him. Now the bullet passes through this gentleman and lands in my grandfather's spleen. Unfortunately, that night, the gentleman who the bullet passed through passed away. And so the police were like, well, we're charging you with murder. So they charged my grandfather and my great-grandfather with murder. So the sensational trial of Fred S. Iozzo lasted a few months, and my great-grandfather was eventually convicted, but convicted of involuntary manslaughter.
That is a crazy story.
Yeah, and part of the sentencing was the family was never able to get our tavern license back, so they were never able to reopen Iozzo's. So in 2009, with some help of family and friends, I decided, let's give it a shot. So here we are serving our famous spaghetti and meatballs. My mother actually came up with this idea to serve the meatball martini. So we found these really cute little mini martini glasses, and people loved it, and we were like, well, let's do it at the restaurant.
And you make your own wine.
We do, yes. We go out to California every year and out of Paso Robles and work with a winemaker out there, Rich Hartenberger, and do a private label wine for the restaurant. So our first vintage was named after my great-grandfather, Santora. So we went out and made a Sangiovese and have it available here at the restaurant. There's a fun little story on the back about kind of an honoring 100 years of our family's history in Indianapolis. What we have here, this is our Zozo shrimp.
Zozo shrimp.
Absolutely. So it's lightly breaded and flash fried and then topped in a sweet spicy chili sauce, served over a bed of romaine lettuce. And it's one of our most popular appetizers.
I can see why.
We also have our lasagna bolognese. It's a five cheese vegetarian lasagna layered up and then served half with our bolognese sauce and half with our Alfredo sauce. Now our bolognese sauce has our veal, pork, and beef, a little bit of heavy cream, some carrots, some celery, a true northern style bolognese sauce. Perfect way to end dinner at Iozzo's is to have a homemade sea salt brownie. So it's a homemade brownie topped with a little bit of Mediterranean sea salt, fresh vanilla ice cream, and we drizzle it with a salted caramel and chocolate sauce. It's absolutely delicious.
Now, people that may not be familiar with downtown, kind of describe where we are right
now. Sure, no, absolutely. We're located in the Stadium Village, just in the shadows of Lucas Oil Stadium, on South Meridian Street, just about a block and a half from Shapiro's, a landmark restaurant up the street.
Katie Harris, thanks for joining us today. We appreciate it. You've got a great history, and you've got a great restaurant.
Yeah, thank you so much. It's a pleasure.
Iozzo's down on the just south of Indianapolis area. They make their own desserts. They make their own wine. You got a pretty good life.
We do. I love it. I love sharing my family's meatballs with the city of Indianapolis.
Very nice. Well, thank you for sharing it with Boomer TV.
Thank you.